happening right here as the Penguins organization honors Marc-Andre Fleury.
We'd like to select from the Cape Breton Screaming Eagles, goaltender Marc-Andre Fleury.
Number 29, Marc-Andre Fleury!
On the edge of tonight, because tomorrow.
Fleury, one-on-one, and a straight touch of goals. Marc-Andre Fleury, nothing short of spectacular here tonight.
Oh, Fleury just made an absolutely ridiculous, sensational save on.
TJ Oshie is down with Scott.
Thank you, Jim. Yes, thousands take the Washington subway to work every day. And here's the king of the metro system. All those people who take it to work don't have a Stanley Cup, but you do. Tell me what you're thinking.
Oh, we all have it now. Oh, man, I don't know. It's hard to describe. Besides my wedding day and my birth of my two girls, this is the most amazing feeling I've ever had.
TJ, let's just talk for a second about life's turns. In 2002, you moved to Waro, your father's hometown. You led Waro to two state high school hockey championships, UND after that, and now you're a Stanley Cup champion. Where's your father, Tim, figuring this win tonight?
Oh, you're making me cry really now. My dad's here in the crowd. He's diagnosed with Alzheimer's, and he doesn't remember a lot of stuff, but you bet your ass he's gonna remember this one.
All right, I guess the last question would be, Brooks Orpik told Brian McClellan, the general manager of the Capitals, that of all the free agents the Caps had last offseason, you were the most important one to sign, and he had a point. How does it feel to reward the faith of the Capitals with the Stanley Cup tonight?
You know, it feels good, but it was so much more than just me or just what I did on the ice. I've never seen a team come together like we did here. And I've been on some really good teams, some really close teams, some teams that I'm still really good friends with, but I've never seen the commitment from start to finish like we had here. So, you know, I really thank Brooks for what he said. And I told Mac that I thought we could win, and we could win a couple before we signed. And it just feels so great to do it with this great group of guys.
Nice when a plan comes together. Thanks for your time. Congratulations.
Sorry. Thanks a lot.
Wow. That's exactly what Pascal Dupuis said, Bob. He saw his lips. He said, wow.
Oh, man. That's touching. And there's a man that left it all. Left it all out there. And there he is with his family. The most important thing, Steve.
Yep, and I have to say, the fans have just been tremendous here. They're still on their feet. They're still cheering for him. And a fantastic job by the Penguins game night presentation crew for putting that video together. It was fabulous because it really, I thought, captured the essence of Pascal Dupuis, the player and the man.
Imagine that point to heaven after that goal was to him.
Yeah, it's a tough day overall, and you know, it's one of my, you know, great friends growing up, and just you know, really sad day. So it's it was important to get the win, but anytime you get someone, you know, taken away from you, that's so close to you, it, you know, means so much. So it was tough to hear that right before the game, for sure.
Just talk about this game and as far as you guys getting back on the right track offensively tonight.
Yeah. I thought, you know, I knew before the game that this team was going to have a good response after the last game in San Jose. That was, you know, a tough loss in a shootout, but a great game overall. So it was, you know, nice to come back and put up some goals. And even though we let in three, you know, we scored a lot tonight, and it seemed like everyone was moving it pretty good, moving it around, even on the power plays. So it was a great effort from everyone, for sure.
I'm guessing Bickle let out a good scream after that goal in the first.
Yeah, it was a great play. You know, Shazzy gave me the puck, and, you know, he kind of made the whole play, coming in and taking away that defenseman. And you know, all I had to do was kind of fake the shot and pass it to Bix, and he wired that one home pretty hard, so I'm sure it was a good feeling for him.
ovation continued through the anthem. Now we're getting to hockey.
Not yet. Not yet. They just announced Zachary Koivu as a starting center ice.
We'll get to our Tim Horton starting goaltenders in just a moment. Up they come again out of the seats. And Dan Mirawelli is not going to drop the puck until they get this out of their system. If he waits that long, we may be here till midnight, because I'll tell you what, it is pouring out of the stands. It is pouring out. This one going to go in the books as one of the most remarkable shutouts in Ottawa Senator history. That one is for you, Nicole. Craig Anderson and the Ottawa Senators, 2-0 winners here tonight. Stand by for your Molson Canadian three stars of the game. Molson Canadian, our team, our beauty. What a personal achievement, but what a team victory, and you can see it in that celebration.
Sometimes he... You know, it's our job to come up with the right words, and I really don't have the right words to sum up what's going on right now, except that's a remarkable performance by the Ottawa Senators, a remarkable performance by Craig Anderson, and a remarkable woman giving him the push to come back to try and help his team.
Boy, that is some moment. 35th career shutout, but none like that before.
A lot of times there's a lot of yelling and screaming when there's a shutout.
Yep.
And as you saw when the camera came down the hall with the players, there was none.
Your second star tonight from your Edmonton Oilers with 20 saves, number 33.
Moment to himself, he's going to be introduced as one of the stars.
And staying on the ice, Cam Talbot, to recognize Craig Anderson.
Number 41, Craig Anderson.
I think that's the loudest cheer in a building for a visiting goaltender after a shutout, and it's just a remarkable moment here in Edmonton.
Sometimes it's just supposed to be.
Great people and a great game, and a special night here in Edmonton.
Here are the fans. Mario's on the ice now. Back to the point, Desjardins. Mario blocked it. Lemieux heading up ice. Here he comes. Here he comes. Mario Lemieux. Hang on. He scores. You gotta love it. Is it not fitting that this game should end just like this? Not over yet, but Mario has punctuated this victory for the Pittsburgh Penguins by scoring one more time on a breakaway in front of his family and his hometown crowd. Yeehaw, man.
Seconds left. Here's Clifford, stopped by David Ayers. The Carolina Hurricanes surround him and defeat the Toronto Maple Leafs 6-3. I'm sure that sweater goes to the Hall of Fame. Number 90 will live on for the Carolina Hurricanes, 42 years of age.
Here he is, named one of the stars of the game, and there's another first, and something he probably never thought he'd get a chance to do. And good for the fans here to show their appreciation of what he had to do tonight.
It's been great. Obviously, that second period was a little shaky, but I told the boys in the dressing room, once we come out for the third, I'll be settled down and ready to win this one.
I mean, your last game of record that we could find was Allen Cup hockey 5 years ago. How would you just describe what tonight was?
It was awesome. Obviously, the time of my life out there. I've been on this ice many times without fans. Put fans in the mix, and it's a whole different game, obviously. But, hey, once in a lifetime, I'll take it.
This is the first open ice big hit that Scott Stevens has thrown in the series. Paul Kariya landed on his back and didn't move.
And Paul Kariya knows not to cut through the middle towards Stevens' side.
And the fans on their feet because Paul Kariya has just come back from the dressing room and onto the bench. Into the zone, Sikora kicked it out, got it back near side Kariya. Kariya, the fans want one. Score!
Gary yet. Look at this shot. Just a laser that was by Marty Brodeur before he could see it. A dramatic period for Paul Kariya.
For Shan. His shot saved, made rebound, kicked out. Alone, scores! Tatar! He looks to the roof. His father just passed away yesterday. And Thomas Tatar, a salute to his dad. He's playing with a heavy heart on this day and tomorrow before he heads home for his father's funeral. And a great way to salute his dad for Thomas Tatar in a 2-1 Red Wings lead.
A great goal. Thomas Tatar has been great all night. Riley Sheehan taking it to the net, shoots it at the net. Tatar goes to the net and buries it to put the Red Wings up 2-1, but Riley Sheehan not shooting for a goal, but for opportunity. Comes off quick. Todd Bertuzzi, middle lane drive. That's what the Red Wings have been doing so well all night long. And then a salute to his father.
The Stanley Cup winning Colorado Avalanche. And after 22 years, Raymond Mark! Telling him, take that thing and skate.
Skate it, baby. Skate it.
We'll follow you.
I'm not sure Ray is going to be able to skate and navigate his way around the ice through his own tears.
Chris Dreyfus said today, we can't wait to hand the cup to Vladimir Konstantinov in the wheelchair. That will make everything we've worked for worthwhile.
It was a great goal. And sadly, the last for Colby Cave. The Edmonton Oilers forward died this morning. My heart is shattered, Emily Caves says on Instagram. Caves' wife sharing heartbreaking photos from the morning when she said goodbye to the man she calls her person and her hero, expressing her pain of being a widow before even celebrating her first year wedding anniversary.
Our thoughts and prayers go out to Colby Caves' family, his wife Emily and her family. It's a terrible tragedy that happened today. And
Cave was hospitalized after sustaining a brain bleed overnight Monday into Tuesday and had been in a medically induced coma. Oilers captain Connor McDavid posting on his Instagram a picture of the player he called Caver. Just doesn't make any sense. Heavy, heavy heart as I try to wrap my head around this, writes McDavid. You were an amazing person and always brought so much energy and positivity to the room.
He was an incredible young man. He was very professional. He was well respected in the locker room. He played hard every day.
Wayne Gretzky taking to Twitter to express his condolences. He was a wonderful player with a bright future, but an even better person. Cave grew up in North Battleford, playing junior for the Swift Current Broncos. He went undrafted but signed as a free agent with the Boston Bruins, where he scored his first NHL goal. From teams to players, Twitter was filled with messages to the Cave family. He was in his second season with the Oilers. Colby Cave was just 25 years old. In Edmonton, Kevin Armstrong, City News.